You came here to learn animation? Let's do it. Hey guys, Sebastian here from Noble Frugal Studio. Last year I released a video called How to Start Making Your Own Animated Series. It's by far my most popular video, and that series of videos is your and my favorite on this channel. Thank you for your continued support as I continue churning out episodes of that series, and I wish you well on all of your animated projects. I did notice though that a lot of comments on the first video were from disappointed people who said I didn't really teach them how to make an animated series. But I think what they meant to say is that I didn't teach them how to make animation itself. Since that video was about making an animated series, going into it, I had already assumed that the viewers would know how to make animation, since making an entire series is a way bigger project. But as it turns out, a lot of you out there want in on this animated series stuff, but you don't know how to make animations. So today, I'm here to answer 5 very important questions so you can get started making your own 2D animations. Make sure to stay tuned until the end, because at the end of the video, I have a huge announcement to make about this channel. Let me get a W-I-T, pro-lighting, it makes my work desk look so inviting. I write things and I brainstorm, but make sure my desk lit, even so my eyes don't ache sore. It's got a wide color temperature range for the folks in the cold and the bros who stay warm. It takes form in a sleek body, high quality, eye care, auto-dimming sensor technology. W-I-T, pro desk lamp, you can get it with the base or buy the desk clamp. The rest can't light your desk on all corners, no borders, soft light in all quarters. W-I-T, pro lighting, adjust the brightness from low to high key. This song was a collab, so I hope that is convincing. So click the link in the description. The 5 questions are, how do I make 2D animation? What do I need to make 2D animation? Should I share my animations? Where and how? Once I start, how do I get better? How long will it take to master 2D animation? So let's start with the first question. How do you make 2D animation? 2D animation is basically the consecutive viewing of different drawings that gives the illusion of movement. You can create this effect by using software to draw your individual frames and then export them to a video file for viewing them in succession. I recommend that you use the free 2D animation software OpenTunes to start making your animations. It's a little bit of work to get used to, but trust me, it's worth it in the long run. In addition to that, I recommend that you download a video editing software to compile all of your animated scenes. I use DaVinci Resolve because it's capable of almost anything, and it's free. You can also make animations traditionally by using special animation paper and a camera to capture your frames. But in order to keep this video as simple as possible, I'll stick to the faster and easier digital animation method. What do you need to make 2D animation? What you'll need to make animation is a capable computer, a drawing tablet, and an animation software. If you plan to make large animated projects with lots of layers and effects, I recommend getting a computer with a decent processor and graphics card. AMD Ryzen processors are great for creative work because they offer multiple threads for multitasking at an affordable price. This will cut down render times and speed up your complex workflow. If you're looking to just make simple animations, then your run-of-the-mill laptop will probably be fine, for 2D animation at least. A drawing or a graphics tablet is a device that you connect to your computer to make drawing easier and more natural. When you plug it in, it replaces your mouse with a pen, mimicking the traditional way of drawing with a pencil and paper. There are 2 kinds of drawing tablets: pen displays, which come with a display and act as an additional monitor, and pen tablets, which don't have a display but are mapped to your computer screen to coordinate the pen. Pen displays are easier and more natural to use, but they're much more expensive. Pen tablets take some time to get used to, but are much more affordable. My advice is that if you're on a budget, buy a pen tablet to help you get used to the world of digital art. After you've gotten used to the programs you're going to be using and you've established a basic workflow, then you should go for the more expensive pen display. But if you're not on a budget, then you can go with whatever your heart desires. By the way, here is an easy to follow animation tutorial for those of you who have purchased these materials and have downloaded OpenTunes already. If you're ready to go, I'm not going to stop you. Just click the link in the card. I also want to mention that you can buy anything you see here on my personal Amazon store, which is full of all the tried and trusted products that I've used over the years. Since Black Friday is coming up, I take a look and see what items you may consider buying on sale in a few months. Should you share your animations? Where and how? It's completely up to you whether or not you want to share the animations you make with the world. an easy and affordable way to share them is on social media like YouTube, Instagram, or any other online community. If you're interested in practicing animation and getting better, then I recommend that you join our Discord channel. We host challenges aimed at beginners and those looking to improve their skills in animation. Winners are actually featured on my channel, so if you join, give it your best. Anyway, if you're looking to make animated shorts or an animated series, then I recommend that you upload your animations to YouTube. This way, you can organize your cartoons by series by creating playlists, and you can earn money from their viewership. A YouTube channel can also act as a home base for your internet brand or your internet presence. Otherwise, if you're really new to animation, and especially new to drawing, you might want to hold off on sharing until you've considered a few things. What I see online all the time, especially with really young people, is that they'll share their rudimentary or their really low effort work online, and then they'll just get blasted by others for it. This is very painful to see and can be hurtful to the artist and the community as a whole. This happens so often that I frequently see people share an animation and they'll say, "It's not good," or "I know it's bad, but here it is anyway," etc. And I believe they say these things so that people don't blast them, but what they're really doing is ruining their self-esteem and their confidence in their own work. It takes a lot of work to master any skill, so why should drawing and animation be any different? If your first few animations don't look good, it just means that you have a lot of practice to do. You can't really be bad at something that you don't have experience in. But also, if you're going to share your work online with a bunch of unknown people, make sure you know what you're getting into. Once you start animation, how do you get better? There are 12 main principles of animation that teach you the basics. If you get to know these well, your animations will start looking professional. The 12 principles are squash and stretch, anticipation, staging, straight ahead and pose to pose, follow through and overlapping action, ease in and ease out, arcs, secondary action, timing, exaggeration, solid drawing, and appeal. Once you master these basic principles, you can go on to the more advanced ones, which demonstrate different types of motion. These include the wave principle, counterposing, breaking joints, accents, leading action, etc. There's a lot. All of these are summarized in this neat video called The 21 Foundations of Animation by The Angry Animator. Once you master each one of these principles, you'll be a highly skilled animator ready for any project. At that point, you can go on to study motion by observing life around you keenly to discover how you can capture it more effectively. After thorough study, you'll probably develop your own principles of animation. The point is that you'll never truly master animation, just as no one can ever be the one true master at any skill. We can definitely get really good at it, but the world around us is far too complex, intricate, and beautiful to ever truly replicate it. The good thing, though, is that we don't have to replicate real life. In fact, you can just focus on what appeals to you and bring that out in your work. Conclusion and final thoughts. Animation is a complicated art, so don't beat yourself up if you can't get past a certain exercise or your animation isn't looking how you want it to. That's easier said than done, you know, the not beating yourself up part, but as long as you focus on mastering the basics first, your journey should stay on track. One thing I'd like to mention is that making 2D animations requires drawing skills. And now before you click away, I want to say, don't be afraid to learn how to draw. Drawing is a really underrated life skill that can help you in a multitude of arenas. Learning how will take time, but that's no reason to toss it out the window. All skills take time. In order to gain proficiency in any skill, you have to practice, you have to fail, you have to succeed, but most of all, you have to learn. Thank you guys for watching. I hope this video helped clear some confusion you may have had about making animation and inspired you to get creative and follow your dreams. I'm going to leave a bunch of links in the description of helpful websites that will aid in your journey of learning how to draw, learning how to animate, or both. Using a helpful course or a guide will structure the learning process and help you recall fundamental information while you animate. Because of the effect that courses have on learning and the development of skills, I've decided to make a completely free animation course here on YouTube, just for you guys. As a student, it's hard to see others who want to learn animation struggling from a lack of structure just like I did. So I plan to make a full-length animation course that takes you from plugging in your tablet to making your own finished cartoons. At first thought, I was going to make this a paid course, but honestly, after all I had to learn with trial and error, in the years it took me to learn simple things about digital art, I reconsidered. So this is for 14-year-old Sebastian and anyone else who wants to make 2D cartoons. If you just let me, I'd love to be your teacher. With all that said, if you want to support the channel, then please consider joining me on Patreon. They'll most likely get to see the course as I make it. But if you don't have the cash, then you can also support the channel by signing up for a free trial of Amazon Prime. There, if you navigate to the Prime Video section, you can watch one of my favorite movies of all time, Ernest and Celestine. So make sure to sign up for a 30-day free trial and just watch this wonderful movie. Man, I gotta watch it after this. That's all from me, guys. I'll see you guys next time. Peace.